Welcome back, our viewers all over the world. And this is a module on radiographic testing formulas. And I'll go through like five or six formulas here. So just we need your attention here. So the first one is called the inverse square law. And the easiest way to explain this one is that if you have radiation I1 at a distance D1, then what happens if you actually double the distance or make the distance three times? So the radiation drops by the square of the distance. So if you double the distance, the radiation will become 1/4. If you triple the distance three times, then the radiation will become 1/9. So here is the formula to calculate that. The next one is half value layer. And in this one, what we are trying to explain is that the radiation drops by half across one half value layer. So if you have two half value layers, then it will be 1/2 times 1/2, which will be 1/4 of the radiation. So the half value layer for concrete is given here. For iridium 192, it's 1.75 inches. For cobalt 60, it's 2.38. And then you will wonder, why is it different? The reason is that the energy level of cobalt 60 is not the same as iridium 192. In fact, it's much higher. And that's the reason the half value layer for cobalt is higher than for iridium 192. Now, if you have lead or some other materials, it will be a different half value layer thickness. So here is a calculation for half value layer. Now, the next one is actually calculating the radiation level at any distance for any Curie strength source. So if you're using iridium 192, the radiation level at 1 foot is 5900 MR per hour per Curie. And so here is the formula for that. You can calculate the radiation level at distance D for any Curie. If it's 50 Curies, you substitute 50 here and you put the distance here. Now, inversely, you can calculate the distance at which the radiation level will drop to 2 MR per hour. And why do we use 2 MR per hour? That is a safe working distance required as per US Nuclear Regulatory Commission for the radiation people who do radiography. So to get that distance, the formula is given here, which is the inverse of this formula. And you put the Curie strength here, which is, let's say, example 56 times 5900 divided by 2. So when I put in 5900, it means I'm using iridium. And the answer is 406 feet. Now that's for the iridium in air. Now let's say when we do radiography, we don't actually expose the radioactive source in air. It's actually enclosed in a little kind of a cup, which is called the collimator. And the collimator actually attenuates the radiation. And whenever we use a collimator, it will actually give you the half value layer thickness of the collimator. So if the collimator thickness is 1/2 value layer, then this 56 will drop to 28. And if it is 2 half value layer thickness, it will drop to 14. So here is an example where the collimator thickness is 4.3 half value layers. So if we use a collimator 4.3 half value layers, then this 406 feet distance will become 91.59 feet. So you see a big difference in the safe working distance. From it drops from 400 feet to 91 feet. And when you're doing radiography, that makes a huge difference for barricading the area. This is simple. What is R and MR relationship? So 1 R equals to 1000 MR. Sievert is a SI unit, and 1 sievert equals to 100 rems, which is a lot of radiation. So 1 sievert radiation is actually deadly. And then this is a formula for attenuation, linear attenuation across any thickness T. Now, the number 7 is actually calculating the Curie strength after number of days. And this is useful when we do radiography. When we buy a iridium 192 source or cobalt, we along with the source, we get a data sheet which says what was the Curie strength on a certain calendar day. And now after every day, the Curie strength will drop. And this is given here, the half-life of iridium-192 is 73.8 days. What it means is that if you buy 100 Curie iridium-192 source today, then after 73.8 days, it will become half of that. So if you buy 100, after 73.8 days, it will become 50. And then another 73.8 days, it will become 25. So here is the formula to calculate the Curie strength after any number of days. So it's CI original, and then 2 to the power of number of days divided by half-life. And this one, you can use it to calculate. So here is an example, it's in small font, so I will let the camera focus on it. So this is calculated after 36 days. And after 36 days, the 90 Curies become 64.2 Curies. This is the formula for law of equivalent exposures used in X-ray radiography if you want to adjust the distance and the exposure time. So you use this formula. The last one is on geometrical unsharpness, and we have a separate video on this subject, but just to put all the formulas in one presentation, UG, which is the blurriness, which is right here, is equal to UG equals to, the formula is here, F is the size of the source size times the distance of the obstruction to the film, which is T, which is also the thickness of the part or the component, and divided by the source to the source to object distance. So if you want to make the shadow or the image sharper, the only way you can do it is to adjust the source to object distance. And so that can be figured out from this formula. Now the codes require that this UG should not exceed 0.5 millimeters or 0.020 inches. So in order to meet the code requirement, we have to back calculate the source to the object distance, and we just can calculate using the same formula, and which is given here. So the S equals to FT divided by 0.02, and that would be the distance at which we will actually get geometrical unsharpness of 0.02 inches. So the source to the object distance equals to the source size times the thickness of the component and equals to S. So here is an example, and it shows you that if the plate thickness is 0.75 inches and the source size is 0.143 inches, then the source to the object distance should be at least 5.36 inches. And if it is more than that's even better. So I covered all the formulas, just kind of review them. And the camera, we played it slowly, so you can really read all the examples and practice. And good luck in your radiographic career and in your NDT career. And we will be adding more videos as we go on.